Good day to you all. This video is the second one in preparations to make these coils over here in the box. Over there. To place them all on the table resonant with our transmitter coil over here and have optimum output. So in this video I'm going to look what happens when we ground our receiver with a capacitor. So if we look at the scope image now, and it is grounded, then is this our output. Now, as we can see over here, the rising edge, so the blue is our pulse, the green is the current, it is measured by a 1 ohm resistor, and then over here we have the voltage output of our series LC circuit of the transmitter. And you can see that the rising edge is perfectly at the maximum top of the voltage that is outputted. So when we go out of resonance and we change the frequency, so we are now at 178 kilohertz and I'm going down, then you see that our rising edge comes at a different moment and our maximum amplitude goes down. This is also for the negative, because this pulse width is one half of the wavelength of the sine wave of our resonant circuit. So if we go up in frequency, so now we are back at 178, and we see we are back at the top. If we now go higher in frequency, so we are now at 179 kilohertz, then you see we are coming to this side of that pulse, and our voltage also, for the sine wave, excuse me, and we also see that the amplitude goes down. So the most optimum position for the rising edge of our pulse is over here. Now what I'm going to do, I'm going to remove that capacitor ground connection, earth ground connection, and we see that the output goes up from our transmitter, but on the other hand, for our receiver, it did go down. But what is important to see is that we have not created a phase shift. So it is still at the maximum level of our sine wave. On the other hand, so when I reconnect that capacitor to ground, on the other hand, when I move our receiver closer to the transmitter, then we see that we have a difference in phase. So I need to change the frequency accordingly. And again, we are now at 177.4 kilohertz. We are back in the middle, but you can see that the amplitude is lower. On the other hand, on our receiver, the amplitude is a little bit higher. But now you see that we are creating a phase shift when removing. So I'm going to place it further away, our receiver. And now you see a huge difference also on the voltage of our receiver. So I'm going up in frequency. And again at 178.2 kilohertz. We are in the middle of that maximum value and we have the highest output. Now, a second point that I want to show. This part of the video, I'm going to show you the difference between the parallel and series circuit for the receiver coil. And it is based on this circuit over here, where I have a switch that gives me the possibility to change over from series to parallel. Now, I will add a link to the video where you can find this picture in my picture album. So what we are seeing over here is our receiver coil over there is tuned to the frequency of our transmitter, and there is a difference between a series and parallel, namely that when we use a series like it is switched now, We can come closer to the transmitter coil, but we don't create a phase shift. We will see that the amplitude goes down of our transmitter, but we see that there is no phase shift. I'm going now to zoom in on the scope image. So this is the scope image again, where we have over here the line where we can see the maximum point from the resonance. And now I will move closer the coil, the receiver coil, to the transmitter. And as you can see, there is hardly any phase shift. There is a little bit, but there is not that much. And I'm real close at the moment. So when I go just a centimeter away, we are back on that top again. So I will now zoom back in on the receiver coil. So this is the distance between transmitter and receiver coil for that result. Now I will go do the same, but I will switch over to parallel. As you can see, I must come much closer before the LED even goes on. So I'm first going to show you the result at this distance. So at this distance, and when we now move closer, we see that we create a bigger phase shift than with the series. If we now zoom in to our setup, then we see that it is much closer than before. But you can see when we go like before, a centimeter like that approximately. So when we go that way, so the LED is not on, while with the series LC it was on. Now I will place the receiver coil into the center. So as we can see, the LED is now on. And if we watch on our scope image, then this is the result. Now I'm going to move that coil closer to the side. And you can see the amplitude goes down. And we have that phase shift over here, going back to the center. Now I'm going to switch to series again. One moment. So this is when we are switching to series, and we see that the voltage is gone. Also, the LED is almost out. When we then move closer to the coil edge, we see this result, so there's not much difference. But we don't have much output. So then when I go higher, but you see when I go up and down, then you see over here that there is almost no phase shift while doing that. In the parallel, you see that phase shift coming. So if I zoom into the coil, what you saw on the screen before, so this is in parallel, and this is when I move up. So approximately at this distance, that is the best brightness that I have. So just on top of the coil. When I switch over to series, then the distance is a little bit higher, where we have the best result. So you can see that also the series and parallel switching of our transmitter can have an influence on the phase shift that we are creating in the transmitter coil. I'm going to see if there are other interesting points to show you. So thank you for watching and hope to see you in the next movie.